So my screen is visible.
Yes, it is.
So hello, my name is Michel Patel, and today I am going to give talk on Richardson-Dustman equation and its physical interpretation. So what are the key points I am going to discuss today? So where it occurs and what it tells. That means which physical phenomena it explains. Then we will try to fill this equation. What do I mean by fill this equation? We will see that this equation is dependent on how many physical quantities and which are these quantities and how much susceptible it is on these physical quantities. And we will try to fill this using graphs. And the value of current density J, which we obtained from the graph, then we will try to interpret it in a physical interpretation of this. And at last, we will see the usefulness of this equation. So first of all, what is thermionic emission? So consider a metal cube, and here in metal cube there will be so many free electrons. So they will move inside this cube randomly with some kinetic energy, and since they are free electrons, their potential energy will be zero. But at surface there will be some non-zero potential energy. It is the same case as a liquid drop. And I can explain this with an example. Consider yourself in a hostel. So as many of you have lived in hostel, so consider that your warden has set a rule that you cannot go outside the hostel after 10 p.m. So your condition like is a free electron. You can move anywhere inside your hostel. You can go in your friend's room, but you can cannot go outside the hostel. So free electrons cannot go outside this, come out of this surface, because this potential will stop them to come outside. But the electrons who are higher kinetic energy, they will surpass this potential barrier and come out of this metal surface. Consider that this is the potential barrier, and here is the electron, and its height is W. So the electron who has higher kinetic energy, they will come out of this potential barrier. So as I increase the temperature, what do I mean by temperature? Temperature is the kinetic average kinetic energy of particle. So as I increase the kinetic energy, more and more number of electron will be able to come out of this potential well. So as I increase the temperature, more and more number of electron will come out of this metallic surface. And the number of electron which are coming out of the surface, it is given by this expression. This current density J is given by this expression. I can also interpret this current density in other words, like current density is current per unit area. And what is current? Number of charged particle at unit surface at in unit time. So what is current density? It is the number of electron coming out of the unit surface in unit time. So this is not none other than number of electron coming out of the metallic surface per unit area per unit time. And this expression is called as Richardson-Dustman equation. Here A is the Richardson constant, and its value for our case is 1.2 into 10 raised to 6. And this phi is the work function of material. It is material dependent. So for specific material, this current density is the function of absolute temperature. And I have given the work function of some of the metals, some common metals. Now we will try to plot the graph of this current density as a function of temperature for different materials, and we will combine them and we will plot them in a same graph. So I have plotted these graphs in MATLAB. I have made a code, a program made in MATLAB, and this graph is taken from that MATLAB code. So initially I plotted it for 270 Kelvin to 330 Kelvin. So you can see that for cesium metal at room temperature 300 Kelvin, the value of current density is 1.3 into 10 raised to minus 25 ampere per meter square. This number is very small. And let see for the other metals. Other metal, they haven't even rise. So this is very small. Here I have given some data that for cesium it is into 10 raised to minus 25. And as the work function increases, increases, the current density, value of current density J tremendously decreasing. This is minus 38, minus 58. It is very small. I can also explain this current density in other words, like the time required for one electron to come out of the surface, metal surface, at which temperature? 300 Kelvin. So for cesium metal, that time is 10 raised to 24 second. And as the work function increases, that time also increases. And it is tremendously increasing, very rapidly increasing. Now let's move further to the other graph. Then I tried to plot this graph for 900 Kelvin to 1000 Kelvin. So for cesium atom at 1000 Kelvin, you can see that the value of current density is 20 ampere per meter square. Again, I have given some data. So as the work function increases, this current density decreases. This is in milliampere range and this is in nanoampere range. Again, let's interpret this in other words, like time required for one electron to come out of the metal surface at 1000 Kelvin temperature. So here you can see this at almost 49 milliseconds, one electron will come out of the cesium surface due to thermionic emission. And you can see that for aluminum atom, aluminum material, this number is 10 raised to 8 seconds. So as phi increases, now you have understood that as phi increases, this time tremendously increasing. This current density is decreasing. So it is very sensitive with material. So it is very sensitive with work function phi. Now, this plot is for 0 Kelvin to 300 Kelvin temperature range. So here all the material graph for all the material is visible, all five metals. So for almost constant value of current density, you can see that the required temperature is different. Here it is around 1000 Kelvin, and for platinum it is around 3000 Kelvin. So it is also very sensitive with, so here you can see that it is sensitive with work function of phi. But another thing you can also notice from this graph, for initial range of temperature, the change in current density with temperature is very low. It is also it is looking like almost constant, but for higher value of temperature, as temperature increases, for higher value of temperature, the current density is very sensitive with temperature. It is increasing very rapidly. So what is the reason behind this? I can let me first give you with mathematical reasons. So this exponent term is the reason for this. As the temperature increases, this negative exponent term will rapidly increases. So we can therefore we can see this type of P. And let's discuss about physics. So मान लो कि आपके पास एक potential well है, उसमें काफी सारे electrons हैं. तो जैसे-जैसे मैं temperature बढ़ाऊँगा, तो उनकी kinetic energy भी electrons की बढ़ेगी. अभी ऐसा तो नहीं होगा कि कोई एक electron की kinetic energy सारी energy कोई एक electron ने ले ली और वो अकेला बाहर आ गया. सारे electrons indistinguishable हैं, तो सबकी energy धीरे-धीरे बढ़ेगी, साथ में बढ़ेगी. अब बढ़ते-बढ़ते एक समय ऐसा आएगा कि वो potential barrier की height तक पहुँच जाएंगे, top तक पहुँच जाएंगे. तो वहां पर जाके अगर मैं थोड़ा सा भी चेंज करता हूं काइनेटिक एनर्जी में, मतलब कि टेंपरेचर में थोड़ा सा चेंज करने पर भी बहुत सारे इलेक्ट्रॉन पोटेंशियल बैरियर को क्रॉस करेंगे और मेटालिक सरफेस के बाहर आ जाएंगे, तो हमें हायर करंट डेंसिटी मिलेगी. तो जैसे जैसे और थोड़ा काइनेटिक एनर्जी बढ़ाऊंगा, तो और नंबर ऑफ मोर नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विल कम आउट ऑफ दिस मेटालिक सरफेस. सो नाउ आई होप यू हैव ऑल्सो अंडरस्टूड दैट this current density is very susceptible with temperature at higher values. The susceptible means its sensitiveness. Susceptible means sensitiveness. So it is very sensitive at higher temperature. Now, this graph is only for the Richardson-Dustman equation, which we are studying in our syllabus, this equation. But in practice, it will be little bit different. This A, this constant A is material dependent. And the modified Richardson-Dustman equation is different from then. And if you want to more study about this, you can refer this reference, research paper. I have given the reference at last. So you can study from that. Now the last point, usefulness of thermionic emission or Richardson-Dustman equation. So this thermionic emission is usually often seen in vacuum tubes, electron guns, and some other electronic devices. So we in previous classes we studied that in Frank Hertz experiment we have used vacuum tubes. So in vacuum tube also this thermionic emission is taking place. So while selecting the material for this cathode, while we are selecting the material of this cathode, what we will keep in mind, what thing we will keep in our mind, that its work function should be high or less. So if I want more current density, or I can say I want more of electrons coming out of the cathode, so what should be this phi? I want answer from students.
Less.
Yes, exactly. It should be less. So if it will be less, I will get the more electron coming out of this cathode. And I have another question for you guys. In Frank Hertz experiment, if I'm choosing the material for this grid, so its work function should be high or less, this grid? Anyone?
I think it should be high.
Yes, you are correct. It should be high. So if the work function will be high, then the electrons emitted due to thermionic emission from this grid will be minimum. So I can minimize the sources of error. So this work function of this grid should be high. And in the original Frank Hertz experiment, they have choose the material of grid as a platinum. So we seen that the work function of platinum is very high. So these are the some points which you should keep in mind while designing this experiment. So this was my small talk on thermionic emission and Richardson-Dustman equation and its interpretation.
Thank you very much, Michelle, for this insightful talk. We really appreciate it.
Yes, it was wonderful.
Yes, wonderful talk. Yes, it was very good. I hope anyone of you has some questions, you can throw them onto Michelle. I think he has came with the shield, evil defense. Yes. Okay, yes, we are already receiving comments. Wonderful job. Yes, it was indeed a very insightful talk. And this is the good thing about when you prepare the lecture, because in Richardson-Dustman equation, I was able to just tell you that what this experiment of Frank Hertz, what this experiment of Frank Hertz would, why we are using this equation, where we are using this equation. But when you go and dig deeper into the subject, when you go and plot these equations on yourself, you can obviously understand that it is not possible for me to cover everything in classroom. But when you go dig deeper into the subjects, you will know those things which I won't even be knowing. That I didn't knew that it was the cathode which was being used was some barium oxide.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was barium oxide with some coating, and I didn't knew that the grid should be high work function material, so it should be platinum grid. So I didn't knew that, but now as I'm listening to it, I'm getting it. Yes. So it should be like this, because the Frank Hertz tube where the experiment is being done is this small. It is just as small as your finger, the first finger. So when you will do your experiment in your MSc physics, so you will see that tube. It is really very small tube. And in that tube, when you heat the filament, there is no way that you can keep the grill from heating. So that grill will also be heated by a very little amount, of course, but it will be heated a little bit. So you don't want electrons from that grid to come out. So yes. So yes, here Ganesh is saying that, can you please once again explain the last slide?
If anyone wants my presentation, or if anyone wants that MATLAB code, so you can contact me after this class. So I will send you the code.